Good morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful summer Monday. Summer is the season of space where the international tournaments take place. And ever since the Paris Olympics 2024 took center stage, the football soccer world, the sporting world has brought to a standstill. The global appeal of the Olympic Games is still alive and well. Thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful summer Monday, coming off an action-packed weekend where, just as it was scripted here on Assam Sports, as you already know, we are focused on the tennis, football, soccer games that are going on in the Olympics. And just as it was predicted, just as the heavens exhibited, we were served with a mouth-watering clash in the finals of the tennis. We are nearing towards the tennis, and like it was written in the stars, Carlos Alcaraz against Novak Djokovic. What a game it was. A master against an apprentice, you might say, but this apprentice is no regular apprentice. Carlos Alcaraz already beat Novak Djokovic this year in the French Open. Novak has never won the Olympic gold medal in tennis. This might be his last dance. The stars were rooting for Novak Djokovic, and finally he's been able to win gold in the Olympics. Novak Djokovic, the great, adding another trophy to his collection. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports. So yes, all the tennis is over, gives us more time to talk about the football soccer games that are going on, where today the men's semi-final clash is about to go down. The men's semi-finals in the Olympics, between games going on between Spain and Morocco is the first game, and I think Egypt and France is the next game. So many games going on, my mind went blank for a minute. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports. Morocco is playing against Spain, a game that was quite a blockbuster, the version of that same game in the World Cup where Morocco upset Spain. In Qatar, this time they are playing in France. It is the men's semi-final clash between Morocco and Spain. As it is going to be mouth-watering later on in the day. France, the host nation, Thierry Henry's future as a manager, as a coach, he's done great so far. He wants to go further and win it. France is a favorite. They are playing at home against an Egyptian side, the African team filled with experienced player like El Neni, who's charging the crew to victory. Is it going to be another upset in Paris after the women's French team were kicked out by Brazil over the weekend, where tomorrow the women's semi-final soccer game is about to go on, where Brazil is playing against Spain and the United States of America is playing against Germany. The Olympics doesn't need advertisement, it doesn't need marketing. It has lived up to its billing and more, and here on Assam Sports, we've been focused on football and tennis. The tennis, finally, the finals came to a conclusion this weekend, where Novak Djokovic was able to defeat Carlos Alcaraz in a two-set game. The last set went to 6-6. It had to be a tiebreak. It was mouth-watering. It was entertaining to watch. The women's also happened, where the Chinese Zen was able to beat the Croatian Becic in the female tennis. She also won gold for China. Athletics went down. A lot of controversy surrounding Takari Richardson and also Noah Lyles, who almost lost. He beat the Jamaican by a stretch of his neck. The Olympics is just what we came for. It's exactly what the doctor prescribed. Football games are going on today, where, like I said, Morocco is playing against Spain, and Egypt is playing against the host nation, France. Is Thierry Henry going to be able to go all the way and lift the trophy, inking his name into the books of young managers to watch out for? The U.S. men's national team is in search of a good manager. Thierry Henry has experience here in the United States. He has a house here in the United States. Thierry Henry, one of the greatest football soccer players in the world. There's no doubt about his technical and his tactical astuity when it comes to the game. He hasn't won anything yet as a manager. This is a chance to lead this French team to win it all, or Egypt are going to be able to cause an upset. It has been an exciting Olympic Games. Who do you tip to win it in the football soccer game? Is it going to be France? Is it going to be Spain? Is it going to be Egypt or Morocco? The dark horses against the favorites. Who is going to be the one to do it? Thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports. There's a lot going on in the sporting world. And as if that is not enough, you know, transfer window is still bubbling. The likes of Conor Gallagher from Chelsea, it has been rumored that Chelsea wants to offload Conor Gallagher. It's a shame that he has to be the one who needs to go. But due to the financial fair play and the clauses, Chelsea has to sell somebody who is homegrown, somebody they can make an extra profit on, and also somebody whose price will fit within the financial fair play. And unfortunately, Conor Gallagher fits all those lists. He's moving to Atletico Madrid. A lot of Chelsea players have to go, not just Conor Gallagher. If you ask me, the game they played against Man City, the defense is leaking. Thiago Silva, that role that Thiago Silva played, it has to be filled, that gap. We need a striker. The Victor Osimhen triangle with Roma, Napoli, Antonio Conte, Enzo Maresco, who is Pep Guardiola's best friend, and maybe the people think that is the only way, the reason why he got the job in the first place, because he doesn't have enough stake in the game, not enough skin to manage a team like Chelsea. But these are the times we're living in. Is that going to cause him to try his best to find a striker? Because that is exactly what Chelsea needs. Victor Osimhen is a conversation, a Romelu Lukaku swap from Roma to Napoli, Osimhen moving to Stamford Bridge. That could materialize if these people at Chelsea are able to do the right business. The defense, they need a defense as well. It's a lot going on also on the other part of the river in Europe, in Italy. Juventus, Federico Chiesa, the new manager, Alvaro Motta, he says he doesn't have need for Chiesa. If you watch Italian football, you know who Chiesa is. Tipped to be one of the new generation of Italian strikers. Unfortunately, injuries have hindered his progress. Juventus want to let go of him. Another player at Juventus, American Weston McKennie, another bright golden generation kid that most people thought would raise the level of the American game. Stints in Europe hasn't been great for him. Juventus want to offload him. There have been talks about the Premier League teams like West Ham, or like the mid-level Premier League teams interested in Weston McKennie. What do you think is the biggest transfer window, news this season so far? The Nico Williams move, I don't think Barcelona are interested anymore. The price range, like back to the financial fair play issue, they have to be able to acquire him in a certain price that fits within regulations. And I don't think Barcelona will be able to do it. They acquired Dani Olmo, that is a good move. Barcelona were in action against Real Madrid over the weekend in the preseason El Clasico. They beat them 2-1. Very entertaining game. Barcelona is looking good this preseason. Amongst all the teams, they are the ones looking great. They are playing tomorrow. On Tuesday, I think Barcelona is playing their final game against Man City, and Chelsea is playing their final preseason game against Real Madrid. But today, France is going to be playing Egypt, and in a few minutes' time, Morocco is playing Spain in the Olympics men's semi-final clash. Like you already know, the forecast 1.0. New Assam Music Collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. What are you not coming soon? Here's Assam Sports Forecast 2.0. Loaded.